Hey everybody, it's a beautiful Wednesday, January the 12th. It's National Pharmacist Day, and it's time for the Wise Guys and Girl, sponsored by Kmart's Pharmacy. They're going to buy the naming rights to the arena where the New York Rangers play, and they're going to rename it Madison Square Gardens. As always, let's start with Sir and the weather.
Well, welcome to spring. Currently 2 degrees, working our way up to a high of 3 above zero tonight, under gray skies, and enjoy it for the next 2 days because we're back into the deep freeze on Friday. And on National Pharmacist Day, we shout out to apothecaries and those who help out in rural areas. They're basically one and the same, where the former is a pharmacist and the latter is also a farm assist.
Ladders? That's Matt's department.
Ladders and lifts.
Always there for a boost.
Always maintain a 3-point contact on an A-frame ladder.
What do you do with the lift, though? Oh,
lifts?
Lift. I think so. Lifts. Sorry.
They go into your shoes.
Lifts and shoes?
What?
No, you're thinking of the tongue. Move on.
Back to the mannequins. Here we go. Well, smiles and laughs are the prescription today on National Pharmacist Day. Pharmacists are integral members of the healthcare team, and they're directly involved in patient care and play a vital role in patient recovery. They're hired by government agencies to decipher unintelligible writings and were probably among the first to define what hieroglyphics stand for. Along with dispensing pills and providing advice on medications, nowadays, pharmacists also administer immunizations. And many are small business owners too, meaning that they change their own light bulbs, but they have to do it 3 times a day for 10 days. It's time for Tunes with Tamik. Tamik, what are we listening to today? Is it the George Strait song, All My RXs Live in Texas?
Are the monks drugs in my pocket?
No, it's good. It's, okay, I'm gonna read you the lyrics from the first little part. I'm gonna see if anybody can get this, okay? This generation rules the nation with version. Music happens to be the food of love. Sounds to really make you rub and scrub. Come on, Venturo.
Ah, to Ducky.
Yeah. I wish I had a prize.
Well, like the title says.
Exactly. So in honor of medical and other types of marijuana that are now legal, we are celebrating musical youth today with really the legendary tune, Pastor Dutchie, which for a long time they tried to make it sound like it was about something else, because no, that's when marijuana wasn't legal. But now we can, you know, actually say what the song is about. So
that is my as a Tim Hortons man, I knew exactly what the song was about.
They were just kids.
I know.
Well, you know, they didn't inhale. That's the most important. They were just passing it around. That doesn't mean they were doing anything else with it. Right? So, yes, that is my pick for today. That song makes me happy. It reminds me of my childhood, of warm. Again, I keep bringing these songs that kind of carry the warmth through, because Lord have mercy, you got to keep that heat until Friday, right, Mark? So Canada's got it. Like, this is the only place you go from like -25 to like +1 the next day. We can't, you know, our bodies can't figure this out. But just keep it warm inside the home. Listen to Pastor Dutchie. Do what you want, do what you will with National Pharmacist Day. But this is the one. This is the one for today. Good song to kind of vibe out.
Excellent. Let's get to Ventures with Venturo. And I think I sense a book coming today. And today it's sponsored by PJ's Pet Center, who wrote the book on bankrupt pet stores. What have you got for us today, Venturo?
You know, today I have a classic for you guys. I'm going to see if any of you can guess this book. The person that wrote the book, his real name is Eric Arthur Blair. He went by a pseudonym name. And a quote in the book says, "All animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others."
I don't know. Mark, of course.
Wow, I don't know. Hoping to go for the sweep today. Animal Farm by George Orwell.
Oh, wow. Now that you say it, I'm like, of course it's Animal Farm.
Mark is on a run today, man. So,
give me something else. I got to get a 6:49 ticket tonight.
Wow. It just shows you the difference in intellect between Mark and I. I was going with Brown Bear, whiskey.
Eric Carl.
I thought that was a pseudonym. Sorry.
Yeah, so this is a great book, right? I went through this book over the last couple of days, and I was just shaking my head how eerily similar it is, what's happening in the book, to what happens in society over and over and over, right? So the book tells the story of a group of farm animals who rebel against their human farmer, hoping to create a society where all animals are equal, free, and happy. Unfortunately, the rebellion is betrayed, and the farm ends up in a state that's even worse than it was when it was ruled by the farmer. So listen, it's a great book. It's one of those books that's going to go on my list of books that my kids should read. Go check it out, guys. And it's Animal Farm by the great George Orwell. Go check it out.
Did you read the sequel? It was written by a vegan, vegetable farm.
George is trying to teach his kids not to rot the boat, right? Because if they take over, it's going to be worse than when you're in charge. There you go. Good one, Vince. Yeah. Good one.
Back to that almond milk again.
Still milking it, Paul. Nice.
All right, so let's get that book and the song into the mythical show notes. And let's get ourselves to this week's edition of The Sizzler, where Vice Principal Botnick and our special guest, Matt Shulman, a quote machine and aspiring Peel custodian, work together to earn a gift certificate to this restaurant. Matt, how are you doing today?
Not bad. Could be better. Could be payday.
That is awesome. You're up against a hot Vice Principal Botnick, who's 2 for 2 so far this morning. And today you will earn valuable Zeller's restaurant dollars based on the accuracy and creativity of your responses and how much they delight the wise guys and girl. A reminder that bonus bucks are earned each time you get Ventura to laugh out loud. And we've got a $4 carryover this week. I have questions in my hand about pharmacies, brought to you by Kmart's Full Service Pharmacy, where a duck can walk in and buy lip gloss. And if you ask him to pay, he'll just say, put it on my bill. Question number one. According to a 2020 poll that I made up for this question, what is the most important skill a pharmacist should have? Matt Shulman.
Having the self-delusion to think that wearing a white lab coat really is necessary.
Delusions for $5. Vice Principal Botnick.
Just hope there are no pharmacists listening to this show, because I'm thinking it's going to be unkind. But I'd say the most important skill is counting to 10 without losing count.
Ooh. Where the world of woodworking and pharmacy collide. $10, one for each finger. Question number two, what does the symbol RX stand for? Vice Principal Botnick.
It actually came from an old vintner's term when asking how much more wine I could drink before it wrecks my liver. No.
Six plus one.
Matt stunned into silence on this one.
Matt Shulman.
I thought it's the Motion Picture Association rating for movies featuring sporty Mazdas.
And here I thought it was, to denote medications that were X-rated, like Viagra.
Matt, how many movies were in that series? Because there was a bunch of them. What was the last one that they made?
It would be,
Yarek 7. There you go. $7 for your response.
curious. Let's go.
Agatha Christie was a famous mystery novelist. What's your connection to pharmacology? Vice Principal Botnick.
To be as prolific a writer as she was must have involved a great deal of medicinal support.
in Dutchies.
With a double double.
Mad Schulman.
I don't know, but it sounds like a case for Miss Marple.
Which one was she married to? She married to which president was Marple's involved with?
Yeah.
$4 and minus one for the reference that nobody got. All right, 10, 20.
Thanks, Donald.
$36 at the Zealous Restaurant, so it's going to be a good lunch and dessert for everybody. Well done, everyone. It is Wednesday, time for Wednesday's Word.
Well, you know, we got to give a tip of the hat to the pharmacists in the front line of our COVID efforts. Anyway, Word has nothing to do with that. Lasix. Lasix is today's word, and that is a medication that's used to reduce extra fluid in the body. Think of all the good uses for that, you know. Deals with heart failure, liver disease, kidney disease, and of course, here in Canada, we can get the generics. However, it's called vitamin P.
That's the first one I've heard that went past K. You know, they went all gangbusters. A, B1, B2, B3, and then they just got to B12, and then K. Okay, we're done. All right, everyone, that is it for us. Thanks to our fans and friends and odds and ends for listening today. Have a great Wednesday, everyone. Good luck in your training, Matt.
Thank you.
You are the wise guys and girl and Matt. You're smarter and happier than you were yesterday.